In order to make circuits work, they do have to have, certain parts of the circuits have to have a certain amount of resistance. And to get that certain amount of resistance, we have these parts called resistors. And that's the parts that I've given to you, and I'll be giving you some more as we go through this later on. Turn in your handbook and in your big blue book of really swell technical information to page R3, I think it is. Our schematic symbol for a resistor looks like this. Just a zigzaggy line like that. In games, we use resistors with a very wide range. In games, we have resistors that are as little as 1/10 of an ohm. And we also have resistors that are 1,000,000 ohms, or even more than that. So we have a very wide range of resistances. In fact, there's one monitor that we use. It happens to be the monitor that's in the Vigilante game there, and also this one under the table that has a 2.2 million ohm resistor. But the size of the resistor has nothing to do with how many ohms it is. Now, I've handed out some resistors to you, and hopefully you have different resistors, but these resistors can be any number of different ohms, and yet they're all the same size. If you look at these teeny weeny little resistors here, first thing you'll notice is that there are no numbers printed anywhere on this resistor. In order to tell what the value of the resistor is, we have this thing called the resistor color code. The resistor color code. And it's real important that you know the resistor color code. You don't necessarily have to memorize it, but you just do have to know the resistor color code. And the color code is there on page R2 and also on page R3. Each color represents a number. For instance, 0 is represented by black. Get a different pen here. 1 is brown. 2 is red. These are in ascending chromatic scale. That is, they're the same way a rainbow is set up, if you know how that works. 3 is orange. 4 is yellow. 5 is green. 6 is blue. 7 is violet. 8 is gray. And 9 is white. Now, if you look carefully at your resistor, you'll see that there are actually 4 bands on it. Now, it may be extremely difficult for you to see those bands. These resistors are pretty damn tiny. And it may also, for the men in this room, it may be difficult for you to tell what some of the colors are, because men have a problem with color blindness that women don't. So you can ask Shirley or Susan when we get later on into this thing what colors your resistors are. But if you look carefully at your resistor, you will see that one of the bands is gold. One of the bands at one end is gold. We're going to start talking about the resistor at the other end. We're going to start talking about the resistor at the end opposite the gold band. So let's take a look. Let's say we have a resistor that is, let's say, blue is the first band, and green is the second, and red is the third band. Forget about the fourth band for the moment, the gold band. We'll start with the other side. Well, how many ohms is this? Let's see. The first band is blue, so that's 6. So we'll write down the number 6. The second one is green. Green is 5. Write down the number 5. And the third band is red. That's 2. This is not a 652 ohm resistor. Okay, this is really important. In a resistor, the third band of the resistor is technically called the multiplier band. It's called the multiplier band. Ooh, what the hell does that mean? Well, all it really means is that this third band tells you the number of zeros to put after the first two digits. In other words, it's telling you to multiply times 10, add 1 zero. 100, add 2 zeros. Multiply by 1,000, add 3 zeros, and so on. Blue, green, red. Blue is 6, green is 5. The red, the third band, is telling me how many zeros to put after the first two. How many should I put there?
Two zeros.
This is a 6,500 ohm, and there's that Greek letter omega. This is a 6,500 ohm resistor. Okay?
We don't know what a K is.
This is a 6,500 ohm resistor. The third band has to be the multiplier because, remember, I said that we have resistors that are a million ohms or so. If the third band was not the multiplier, if you just wrote down the number it was, what would be the largest value in ohms you could have with three bands? 999 ohms. Yeah, 1,000. 999 ohms. So unless you want to have a resistor that's this long just so you can put all the zeros in there, somehow you have to do it a different way, and so this is the way we do it. The third band is the multiplier band. We're going to go through a bunch of these things, and then we're going to do a little resistor lab in just a second so that we'll have a good idea of how this works, because it's real important to know the color code. All right, let's say that we have a resistor like this one. Let's see, grab another color here. Let's say we have a resistor that is, I only have four colors, so we're going to have to fake this. Let's say we have a resistor that's green, red, orange. Beautiful orange, all right. All right, green is?
Five.
Red?
Two.
Orange? Three. 523 ohms, right?
No.
No, Randy, you dumb shit. What is it? It's three zeros, right? One, two, three, 52,000 ohms. Okay, let's do a couple more. Let me just, instead of trying to find the color here, let's say we have one that is, let's say we have one that's yellow, violet, yellow. Yellow? Four, violet, yellow, four more zeros, right? One, two, three, four, 470,000 ohms. Don't try to do this in your head because it's very easy to slip up and lose a zero or something somewhere. For instance, you might have a resistor like this that's brown, black, yellow. Instead of trying to do this in your head, look at it and say to yourself, okay, brown. Brown is one, black. Black is zero, yellow is four. Four zeros, one, two, three, four. And then put the comma in and see what the hell you have. Because it's very easy to drop a zero or add one accidentally, especially when you get into something with a large number of zeros. So don't agonize over it. Just write it down. Just write down whatever it happens to be. Let's say we have one like this. Let's say we have one that's red, violet. Let's go nuts. Red, violet, green. All right. What's red?
Two.
Violet?
Seven.
Green?
Five
more zeros. One, two, three, four, five. See, 2,700,000 ohms, right? So it is actually very simple once you've done it a few times, and we're going to have a chance to do a bunch of them here. All right, now put on your thinking caps. How about this one? Suppose we have one that is brown, black, black. Brown, black, black. What do you suppose brown, black, black is? What do you think?
One.
1 ohm? Anybody think anything else? 100 ohms? Anybody think anything else?
Point to 10.
Point what? What was that, Dan?
10 ohms.
10 ohms? All right, how many think it's 1 ohm? How many think it's 10 ohms? How many think it's 100 ohms? Who thinks it's 10? Okay, 10 ohms is correct. 10 ohms is correct. Let's see why. This is kind of, this is a tricky thing, but there's a reason why I point this out to you. Okay, brown is 1. We got that. That's easy. Black is 0. Okay, the third band is telling you the number of zeros to put after the first two. How many?
None.
Zeros. Don't put no freaking zeros back there. It's black. This is a 10 ohm resistor. If that third band is black, it's saying don't put no zeros back there, none whatsoever. You do put the second one in there. That's normal. That's a significant digit, as they would say. But the multiplier says don't put any zeros back there. Here's why this is important. You need to pay attention. This is very important. Let's say that you were working on something, and for some reason you found this resistor. I'll get it.
Fine.
All right. Let's say you're working on something and you see this resistor. Resistors, by the way, are the last thing that you test. Resistors hardly ever fail. I'm covering them first, but they hardly ever fail. But let's say for some reason you're working on something and you see this resistor and it's brown, black, black, and you think to yourself it's 100 ohms. Most people think it's 100 because they go 100 and they think it's 100 ohms. I'm really surprised that so many of you thought it was 1. And they get to the thing, they see this resistor, and for some reason they want to check it. So they put their meter on ohms, as we'll do in just a little bit. They put their meter leads across the resistor, and the meter doesn't read 100 ohms. It only reads 10 ohms, which is what it really is, right? They go, oh, I'm a genius. I found it. This resistor's partially shorted. It's supposed to be 100 ohms. It's only 10 ohms. So you boogie over to Radio Shack, and you get a 100 ohm resistor to put in there. You may not notice that the colors are different. You know, it would be brown, black, brown, wouldn't it? If it was 100 ohms, it would be brown, black, brown. So you may not notice that the colors are different. You go ahead and replace that 10 ohm resistor with the 100 ohm resistor. Obviously, when you turn the thing back on, it doesn't fix anything, does it? Because you've not only changed a good part, but you've changed one with a part that's the wrong value, right? You made it worse because even if you eventually find which part is actually bad, you may never get it to work because this new resistor you put in there is 10 times the value it should be. So here's why I point this out to you, and this is really important. It has to do with the way things fail. When a resistor fails, it always open circuits. It goes way up in resistance. When a resistor fails, it never goes down in resistance. In fact, the only time you would ever see a resistor that was lower is if you look at the board and it's just a little chunk of carbon or charcoal sitting on the board, obviously all flamed out, in which case you'd find it by looking at it, wouldn't you? Visual inspection, by the way, is critically important. It's really important to look at jazz. I find about half my problems just by looking at them. That's why if you're in a dark location, it's really important that you have a good trouble light. You know, this business of you know, you got the pen light, flashlight in your mouth like this, and you're trying to work or something like this, and you know, that's nonsense. You really have to have a good, strong light to be able to see what you're doing. But again, when resistors fail, they always go way up in resistance or infinite resistance. So, like, let's say you have a resistor that's supposed to be 470 ohms, let's say, and it's bad. It will be open. You'll put your meter leads across it. Your meter will read an infinite resistance. And we're going to do a resistor lab in just a few minutes here so you can see what I'm talking about. You will never, ever see a shorted resistor. Never look for one. It will always go way up in resistance. So, does that make sense so far about the color code? Now, they do have these little gadgets that you can get at Radio Shack, these little thumb wheels that you can rotate to line up the colors, and it tells you what the value of the resistor is. It's really hardly necessary. It's important that you remember the color code, though, and there's a few little jingles that you can use to remember the color code. These are the first letter of each word of the jingle is the first letter of the color. For instance, there's three that I know of. There's a really clean one that I learned in Boy Scouts. That's better be ready or your great big venture goes west. Better be ready or your great big venture goes west. That's kind of queer. You know, it's kind of stupid. But if you're the drinking type, I got a good one for you. Bad beer rots our young